Hi all, welcome back. It's December of 2020. Sometimes it is sunny and other times it's rainy with clouds. My clothes are not drying properly. Anyways, I prepared few snacks and meals for kids to enjoy this chilly December evening. So I'm sharing them. They're very interesting and unique recipes. So I hope you enjoy watching them. Well, I feel very lazy to go into the kitchen and cook in this weather. So to accompany me and to lift up my moods, I like to listen to some music while cooking. Here I'm preparing hot and sour chicken soup for kids along with chicken noodles. First, let's prepare the soup. For this, I'm taking 1 tablespoon of butter and heat it. Into this, I'm going to add 3 to 4 cloves of garlic. Also, I'm going to add soup later. Here I'm adding Worcestershire sauce, which adds a very different unique flavor, Chinese flavor to the dish. Also adding green chili sauce along with soya sauce. Now saute the garlic nicely. Into this I'm adding 1/4 cup of onion, which I have chopped, and 2 tablespoons of peas and 2 tablespoons of spring onions. You can add vegetable of your choice like cauliflower, peas or carrot, whichever you want. Now when the vegetables are nicely fried, I am going to add boiled and shredded chicken 1 cup. Now nicely mix it. Also going to add 2 tablespoons of maida or all-purpose flour. This is to give a thick consistency to the soup. Now nicely mix it and cook it on low flame. Into this I am going to add 3 cups of chicken stock. I had already boiled chicken pieces into 3 cups of water. Took out the chicken pieces and used the stock in the soup. Since the chicken stock is salted, I'm not going to add salt. I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of soya sauce, 2 tablespoons of green chili sauce and 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. You can add salt if you want to, and you can adjust the taste and consistency of soup according to your preference. Now give it a good mix and cover and cook it on low flame for up to 10 to 15 minutes or until it is nicely cooked. It's been cooking for 10 minutes on low flame. Now I'm going to add in chopped coriander leaves and I'm going to check for the consistency. Now this looks okay. I'm going to turn off the flame. I served this soup as a starter for kids and they enjoyed it nicely. Later I served chicken noodles. For this, I've boiled the noodles according to the instructions in the pack. And for the noodles to be non-sticky, I'm going to wash it thoroughly with running cold water. Now, this ensures that the noodles are non-sticky and perfectly cooked. Into a pan, I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of oil. And into this, I'm going to add 1 large-sized onion, which I have chopped finely. Also adding spring onions, chopped spring onions around 2 tablespoons. Now stir fry it nicely. Now into this we can add vegetable of your choice. Here I'm adding some French beans, some tomatoes which I had, just adding for a little bit of vitamin C. You can skip tomatoes if you want to. Adding 1 capsicum. I think capsicum is compulsory in any of the Chinese dishes. And also adding some boiled chicken. I have already boiled and shredded chicken and kept it. Now mix it nicely. For a simple shortcut, I'm going to add Ching's Szechuan fried rice masala. I'm going to use it to make fried noodles. Sometimes it is good to take some shortcuts while cooking, just to, you know, for some free time and some little less efforts in the kitchen. So I'm adding this masala, which is shockingly very easy. You just need to fry the vegetables, add in the masala. Nicely cook it for a couple of seconds. It is important to cook it for a couple of seconds and then add your boiled noodles or boiled rice, whichever you want. I am adding boiled noodles to prepare Szechuan fried noodles. Now mix it nicely. I am using 2 spoons because it is tricky to mix it with just 1 spoon. Now mix it nicely and serve. So that's it. Chicken noodles are ready. Yes, my kitchen is very messy, but that's not the point. The noodles turned out very yummy. and it was a perfect accompaniment along with soup. A wonderful and warm way to spend this chilly December evenings. The noodles were super non-sticky and the soup was perfect with perfect flavors. The next day I observed the sun was out for a longer time and it felt little warm. The weather was really beautiful. And for today's snack, I'm going to prepare something very interesting, very easy, but very interesting and unique. Here I'm going to take grated cheese. I've used white cheese, which is processed cheese. If you want, you can use mozzarella cheese. Mozzarella cheese gives it a very nice effect. And into this grated cheese, I'm going to add food color. Just for a different kick, I'm adding blue, red, green, and yellow. Now mix the food color nicely with grated cheese. And you can see they look so pretty. They look so cute. And for this dish, I'm going to layer the cheese on top of bread. Like so, you can experiment with the colors and also experiment with the patterns. Use any white cheese to prepare this dish. Now I'm going to go ahead and toast this. This is yummy cheese sandwich. It bursts out in beautiful colors and patterns. It looks so pretty. Preferably use butter to toast the sandwich. It gives a very nice flavor. Now toast it very nicely until the cheese nicely melts. And you can see the excitement in your kid's face when they have it. It's going to look so wonderful and it is so simple to make. And it tastes so super delicious. I don't know anyone who doesn't like cheese and bread. I think everyone loves cheese and bread and it looks so pretty. You must try it. It is simply easy, unique and very different. Your kids would definitely enjoy it. Now this recipe is approved by me and my kids alike. So do try this. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thank you for watching. Bye guys.